What's going on, y'all?
Man, I'm over here, man. I was just chilling. I had some time, man. So I came to the set, man, popped open a book. You know what I mean? And I was just thinking, man. Like, the more and more people that I come across, right? You know, they comfortable in being where they are. You know, they comfortable being lost. You know, for instance, right? I talked to a whole bunch of, you know, women, right? And I even, you know what I'm saying, when I talk to the homies, right? It's always, you know what I'm saying, they know they need to do better, right? They know they need to do more. They know they need to change their ways. But then when it's stopping, when I say, what's stopping you? They act like they don't, but it's them. Because they're comfortable. They say that they want, no, you don't. If you really want something, you're going to go after it, right? When you want that check, right? What do? You go to work every day, right? You put in the work every day, right? When you really want something, you go after it. And it's proven. And it's proven amongst mankind. You people don't really want change. You people is comfortable, you know what I'm saying, being where y'all at. You comfortable living in ignorance. You comfortable not having. You're comfortable being a part of the have-nots. You know what I'm saying? That drive is not in y'all. You know? Y'all was man, maybe this should be alive or something. I don't know. But yeah, man, it's just, you know, everything, like I always say, man, everything that y'all do, good or bad, is because of you. Not me, not your mom and daddy, not anybody else. It's because of you. You chose to accept less. You chose to go down that path that you know was faulty. You chose to get in that relationship that you knew that was faulty. And then now when you experience the results of not only that faulty behavior or that faulty path that you chose on your own, now you move in fear off of your decision making. You move in fear off of your decision making. When you look at, like I said, when you look at everything that you have done, and you look at all the relationships that you have been in, it's all been in your fault. You chose to get in them situations. And now you allowing, see, a lot of y'all don't know how to make the right decisions. Let's just be honest with you. Y'all don't. Y'all choose not to. Y'all choose the life that y'all live. You don't want more. You don't want better. It's impossible for somebody to want more and better and just be complacent and not do anything. That's impossible. That's really impossible. It's really impossible not to follow the blueprint of what need to be done. The blueprint is out here. You see a whole bunch of people following the same blueprint. When you hear people talk about success and the relationships and all that, they tell you it's the same blueprint. But yet y'all choose not to follow it. That's your fault. That ain't nobody else's fault but yours. So quit crying. Talking about I want this. You want to blame other people for your mistakes, for your decisions, for your faulty decisions. No, it's your fault. It's your fault. Man, I see men and women don't like to take accountability for their actions. It's your fault. It's your fault that you can't get the woman that you want because you don't put yourself in the position to get her. It's your fault that you can't get the man that you want because you don't put yourself in the position to get him. And then you get mad because you attract what you are, which just ain't shit. Let's be real. Soon as I change my mind, I do not have a problem, right? Yeah, I still roll through BS, but I don't entertain it because I know that I'm bigger than that. I know I want more than that. I don't entertain it. So it's nothing for me to get what I want. You know? Yes, you know what I'm saying? Don't fall on trees where you can just, you know what I'm saying, go to an apple and a lemon tree and then pick it off. You know what I'm saying? Yes, it's not like that, especially in today's time. But I have the understanding and have the willpower to know this is not for me. So I'm not about the entertainment. So I see signs that's like, you know what? That's a poor representation of him. That's a poor representation of her. So I'm going to choose not to deal with them in the business aspect. I'm going to choose not to deal with them on a personal aspect because look how they conduct themselves. Look what they're doing right now. So if they're doing that now, just think of what they're going to do in the future. And that saves me a whole bunch. Like, for instance, man, I had to dismiss this woman, right? Because she kept telling me that she was going that she was gonna call me at a certain time, you feel me, whatever the case may be. But she never kept her word on that. She was always playing games, you know what I'm saying? Like it was just something to do. No, one thing for sure, my time is valuable. So when she called and she texted, I never replied. You know what I'm saying? And I don't plan on replying. So I said, I'm cool. Come to find out, when she gave that explanation, she was playing. Yeah, she just not used to a man not dealing with that BS. She used to playing them games and men entertaining them games. I would not entertain them games. I would not fold for what I stand on. You know what I'm saying? See, y'all deal with people who choose to play games. I'm not playing no games. I ain't Big Sean. I'm not playing. See, why would I want to play games with my life? Why would I play games with my life? That's just being a lunatic. That's ludicrous. Why would I play games with my life? Why would I accept BS from you when I don't have to deal with you? I didn't know you years ago. I just met you. Now I'm about to deal with your shit? Hell no. Nah. Get your ass to the curb, man. Get out of my way. Either you gonna rock with me the way that I want you to rock with me, or I'm gone. Come on. If you ain't being nothing but a liability in my life, you ain't benefiting my, I'm gone. I'm gone. I tell women all the time, they be like, what would it take for you to leave? You stop doing what I want you to do. Even if we 10 years, hell yeah. Hell yeah. I ain't got time to waste. I'm on a mission. I'm going to achieve it. You know? Our relation, you know what I'm saying? It's, you know what I'm saying? I want to, you know, and what I want to achieve. See, it's three goals that I go about every single day. Relationship goals, financial goals, health goals. Those are the three that I work on a daily. And you guys should too. Whatever you want, that's what you got to put around you. You know what I'm saying? You know, I look at myself as a, you know what I'm saying? I'm marketing myself. It's a walking market. For instance, you know what I'm saying? I train, right? I just go to the gym and do my thing, and all of a sudden, people is intrigued by my level of dedication and the way that I go hard in the gym, and they want to, you know what I'm saying, it motivates them. They want to get some too. Are you a trainer? Yes. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because I put myself in position, not only with the knowledge that I know, but I represent myself in what I say I'll do. If I say I'm a man, I'm going to represent myself in a manly way. If I say I want to go far in the business world, what do I need to do? Not only conduct myself, put myself in position, build relationships, you know what I'm saying? It's a process. It's a process that not many are willing to go through. You understand me? So I just want to be brief. About to get up in here, man. Go get this cut, man. But I just had something on my mind that I wanted to chop it up with you about. But yeah, man, we about it here.